By saying how they did, I mean my videos, bro. First of all, the Iron Fist badge will not work with vehicles anymore, meaning that tank drivers and pilots can't benefit from it anymore. Just like infantry first, they will only work with infantry weapons. The first aid kit can be unlocked sooner at tactical ribbon level 2. All the RTS badges are now unlocked through the battle ribbon. The barrels of all anti-air guns can now be fired in pairs, left click for one half, right click for the other half. Scroll to toggle zoom and R to reload. All this apply to both stationary and mobile in the air. Also, the rate of fire, ammo capacity, and the armor damage they deal have all been increased. So maybe you can save your money and buy an anti-air truck instead of a captured PTSD. But you do you. I understand the PTRS is easier to hide. From the eyes of a pilot, that is. The tier 2 and tier 3 recon vehicles now come with both armor piercing and high explosive rounds. The tier 1s still fire regular ammo.
Know your fucking place, trash!
The Greyhound received an additional MG on top for a third crewman, which personally I consider a nerf, because the gunner now has to expose himself before entering the driver's seat to drive away. They fixed an issue causing very specific attack angles on the Puma not to count as hits. They haven't done so for the Floppa tank, but even if they do, I can use my boys as mid shields. Just remember not to shoot at the wheels or skirts, and if you do, as long as the base structure is behind it, you will deal damage. Parachute mechanics have gotten a rework. You can't open your parachute 1 mm above the ground and expect to survive anymore. By default, the parachute now opens at 90 meters above the object right below you, and if you don't want to lose a single health point when using the freefall badge, you need to open it at 50 meters or above. And if you just want to survive with at least 1 HP, you need to open it from 30 meters or above. Opening it at a high less than 30 meters will kill you no matter what. I'm not entirely sure how the backup parachute works, but from what I understand, if you land on anything but the earth, you can still spam space to open it, which you don't want to do anymore, even if you jump from a small height that otherwise wouldn't kill you. So it may be worth keeping the freefall badge if you don't want your parachute to open automatically by accident and die from a height that otherwise wouldn't kill you. Same rules apply for the pilots. If you eject from your plane below 90 meters, it will open as soon as the eject animation is complete, and if that happens above 50 meters, you won't lose a single HP. So I expect us to see less noobs wasting time running around in the fields because they survived the fall and they didn't know how to undeploy. Speaking of noobs, let's talk about the tank changes. First of all, they did minor adjustments to the statistics of all tank cells in the game. So if you want to see the exact statistics, check this calculator here. But if you don't care about details, the in-game description is fine. Small note, the T-38 can't actually penetrate 55 mm of armor. This is just a mistake that was fixed and it's not updated in the calculator. Now, to help you get the bigger picture of all these minor adjustments, the correction angle has been decreased in all cells, so sloped armor and angling your tank has more meaning, and ricochets are more likely if you don't aim for weak spots. The armor piercing cells are the starter cells, and there are decent all around. The up he up chi and up the others have the best damage and often better penetration than the AP rounds. The APCR and flap have the same damage as AP cells. They have the best penetration, but that penetration drops off drastically the further away you are. And the hit cells have the lowest damage and decent penetration, but they don't lose their effectiveness no matter how far away the target is. There is a lot more to say about how to use these cells effectively and the ones that are to be used against infantry and soft targets, and I can finally now make a video about them without the fear of it being outdated 1 week later by an update, so subscribe for that. The tier 1 light tanks can't one-hit kill infantry with high explosive bullets anymore, except for the M2A2. I mean, it has a 50 cal man, but it shoots slower now. Also, their armor damage and penetration values have been increased, so if you are very close and behind an enemy tier 2 light tank, you can give him the bat sex. They increased the armor damage all light tanks deal, so basically most light tanks can kill each other with 3 or 4 cells. These two got a buff in their armor and less camera shake. These three can reload a bit faster. They increased the armor damage all medium tanks and medium tank destroyers deal. This chomky boy that I trust talked in the past now holds armor piercing, high explosive and APCR rounds in the turret cannon. Very excited about that. This chomky boy, however, can still suck my dick. The American 90 mm cannons that you can find on heavy and heavy tank destroyers are a bit more powerful now. The penetration value for the Tiger 2 and Yak Panther armor piercing round is weaker now. All anti-tank cells for the IS-2 and S-100 deal a bit less armor damage now, and the reload times have been adjusted. In conclusion, light tanks and medium tanks can now kill heavier tanks more easily if they flank or get behind them before they turn around. Moving on to the planes. They increase the high explosive ammo in bacteria, but they decrease their damage, meaning that you need more bullets and to be more accurate to kill infantry. However, they increase the rate of fire for most machine guns and cannons, so I'm not sure if killing infantry is truly harder now. I don't know, you tell me in the comments. Fighter bombs now do more armor damage, so you don't have to zabloing that often. The AP rounds have good damage but lower penetration, so they are better suited for planes and soft targets. The APCR rounds have the same damage as them, but with better penetration, but their range is limited, so they are better used when strafing tanks or any target that is within range, so maybe even planes. The recon planes now deal almost double the armor damage they used to, they got a 25% health increase and a slight improvement in their maneuverability and speed, and they all fly the same. However, their magazine size is still quite small to make up for the rate of fire increase, so you better drop these bombs early and start resupplying. Nonetheless, recon planes kill each other a lot faster now, so you can make lots of money and XP in that game mode if you know how to fly. The tier 2 planes all fly the same, they have the best turn abilities and can outmaneuver most other planes horizontally. The tier 3 planes all fly the same, they have the highest speed and climbing abilities and can outmaneuver planes vertically. And the tier 1 planes fly the same between them, but don't really shine in any specific way. Heavy planes got an 18% health increase and all 3 fly the same. As a note, the heavy and Soviet bombs are stronger than the German, but his cannons and machine guns are stronger to make up for it. And finally, they fixed lots of bugs and did some polishing, like adding a warning when ascending multiple factions to the same key. They added collision to most machine guns so they can actually absorb bullets and protect the gunner, and you can't pick up weapons through walls anymore, and lots of other stuff that you may or may not notice. However, the holy floating factory spaghetti monster hook still remains for us to prey upon. The holy hooker. And the broken paraplane pathfinding also remains. I mean, it has become a signature funny moment at this point. And there is still no confirm your purchase button, or undeploy button on the menu, or less glitching on the menu, or optimization. Alright, I may be a bit harsh here. It's good to see that they keep taking steps to the right direction and fixing as many things as possible in the way. They have started to be more transparent by introducing their developer update blogs, and their new release schedule seems promising. Basically, they will have 2 updates per quarter of the year. A major one with a new battle pass and hopefully new content for everyone as well, and a smaller update with bug fixes and balance changes, just like this one. Hopefully now this schedule will allow them to test the releases properly, because until now they were releasing updates monthly, and they were mostly rushed, so lots of bugs remained undetected upon release. They also have a quality assurance team now, I guess. But still, if you are a fan of the game and you want to help out, join their Discord server. They make announcements there every time the prototype version is open, which is basically a version of the game with all the new content or balance changes they plan to release, and there is lots of gold for you, so you can test everything you want and maybe find some bugs. Now, for those who keep asking me to give my opinion, I like the update. I am mostly excited to try the M3 Lee and the recon vehicles with my friends, which is basically my favorite thing to do in this game. I don't see something wrong with the tank balance changes. Yes, the light tank versus light tank combat might be a bit shorter now, but I don't mind it. I mean, it can still take long if you don't destroy any components, like the ammunition rack, as you should. And now light tanks can finally destroy heavier targets if they manage to properly flank them and sneak behind them before they turn around. I mean, you still could if you manage to get their turret ring and maybe their engine or transmission, but having to shoot them 20 times to do so didn't make much sense. As for the planes, I really don't fly that much, but I asked the opinion of those who do, and they say they liked it. They believe the dogfights have become a lot more balanced and dynamic. They don't have to zabloing into tanks to kill them, since bombs can finally do that for them as they should. The anti-air is an actual threat to them and a target to consider, and not just an inconvenience. But they are a bit worried for the new and inexperienced pilots, since having a good aim and a good knowledge of your plane has become a lot more important if you don't want to die instantly. If you are such a player, you can start learning the basics by watching Wolfie's pilot tutorials, they're pretty nice. And if you don't think planes are worth your time, then maybe the modages from Max might change your mind. And that's basically it. Holy shit, this script was long. Alright, this time a friend of mine wanted to sing for the outro, but I would be the one who chooses the song. So yeah, thank you for watching, I will see you as soon as I finish editing the next video. Ciao ciao, and Mario, take it away bro.
Keep shaking your heads faster.